guys, what's up? It's me, Priscilla. Now, I have a very interesting topic today. Right now, you might be participating in Inktober, or you may not be. Who knows? It's a challenge. It's a drawing challenge. Now, if you've never heard of Inktober, it's where you draw an ink drawing a month. I mean, like, not a month, like every day of the month. So that's about 31 ink drawings. Now, there are a lot of drawing challenges throughout the year. There's like Mermaid, there's Huvember, and then there's Inktober. There's all these drawing challenges out there. And I mean, some people even do like a prompt list for a certain day for the month. Like, they do it throughout the entire year. There's always these drawing challenges. Now, you're probably wondering, how can these drawing challenges benefit me? Someday, when you grow up and you want to go to college to be an artist, I actually, for a design for costumes for the stage class, had to keep a sketchbook and I had to draw 7 days a week. Like, I had to turn it in. So every day of the week, I had to draw something in the sketchbook. I actually had to draw my hands twice every week, along with some things from life or just something else in general. Like, I actually drew a lot of characters and he actually forbid me from drawing any Disney characters or anything like that. But this was the class that I got into watercolor with and into the original inking, cross-hatching, everything. Now, I'm going to talk to you about how can you accomplish drawing every day. So these drawing challenges can prepare you for the future just to draw every day. Plus, it just really helps to draw every day. The more you practice, the better you get at your art and craft when it comes to drawing or painting or inking, whatever it is. These challenges help. The best advice I can give you is to, one, carry a small sketchbook. You see how small this is. This little sketchbook is like a 5x8 moleskin sketchbook. You saw it at one of these videos way before this. I started a brand new sketchbook and I filled it with some of my favorite things I drew myself and your suggestions from Instagram. So carrying this small of a sketchbook, it's easy to take it from place to place. It fits in every single one of my purses. It's just nice to take around. I take it to work. I was drawing in the car. I take it everywhere I go just because it is a mobile sketchbook. It's just, it goes with me everywhere. Don't do anything too extravagant. Just draw something small. So drawing something small and not into crazy detail, like for example, if I do a drawing like I'm doing this autumn fairy here, you can see that I have the flower palette and I have my inks and everything. You don't have to do that. Try to keep it as simple as possible. Carry a few Copic markers or just alcohol-based markers, or just like carry a little bag. I actually have a little bag I'm getting ready to take with me on a trip to Florida. And it's a little bag and it's all I have. I've got like a couple of things and my sketchbook. I'm trying not to go too crazy with how many things I take, but being able to have a small sketchbook that you keep everything together and to have minimal details, as into you don't have to do this big extravagant piece. You are just drawing for yourself. Always show what you do and just, you know, accountability. Try to share it on social media to show how you progress throughout the month. But drawing every day, the best way to succeed is to just keep it as minimal as possible. Keep it short and simple and just draw every day. And it helps you, builds you up for the future. You never know where it's going to lead you, but you might end up like me where you're sitting in college one day, or any art. Even when you get your big job and you're working for your animation studios of your dreams, you could have the possibility that you have a lot of deadlines and you have to get these things done. You have to get these sketches done. So it does prepare you for the future. So getting, like, pushing yourself and everything, it does help. And that's the secret. Just keep it minimal and just do it for yourself. You don't really have to do it for anyone else, but if you want to, an accountability, post it, but make sure you just keep it simple. Draw something small. You don't have to take up an entire 11x14 piece of paper. try to keep it small. Like, there's been some days on Instagram that I posted little teeny tiny drawings, and I go on to the next page, or I share the same page for the next, like, Inktober day. That's the best I can suggest when it comes to these things. Any drawing prompts, this is the best advice I can give you. So if you haven't done a drawing challenge yet, make sure you try one, whichever one you haven't done before. If you're gonna do Hue-vember, which is like different hues of all of November, or I do like a December draw, like calendar countdown to Christmas, it's just fun. It's all fun, but it's for you, and it's going to prepare you for your art career. I hope this helps, and I will see you all later.